You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
May the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Resurrection, the Spirit of Faith, which is the Spirit of the altar, be with all those who are participating in this program. In the name of the Lord Jesus, my dear listener, wherever you are, the Holy Spirit is with you. But it's not a matter of only He be with you. You also need to be with Him. And this has been the difficulty with many people. In a little, I'm coming back to talk about the Spirit of God. That's it. Listen, my dear listener. God, He has been offering the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Resurrection, God's Spirit, His Spirit, in order for us to overcome, the Spirit of doubt. Because just as the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of faith, the Spirit of doubt is the devil's spirit. And no one is capable to overcome. It is impossible a person to overcome this world being filled, let's say, with the spirit of doubt, or being in doubt. So it is impossible for you to overcome this world with doubts. That is why God has given the Holy Spirit. He has given the Holy Spirit to all those who believe, all those who surrender, all those who prove to be and that want to follow Him. All those who sacrifice their lives for the Lord Jesus, they receive His Spirit. And then they have the capacity to overcome the world. This is what the Bible says. Pay attention to this verse. The Bible says, "For whoever is born of God overcomes the world." But to overcome the world is a lot. It's a toll. To overcome the world, the whole world, for you to overcome the whole world is something extraordinary, magnificent. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, is our faith. So, God's Spirit is the Spirit of faith that gives us power in order to overcome the world. So then you may say, "But Bishop, I have the Holy Spirit. I have the Holy Spirit. But I cannot overcome my own personal problems. How can I overcome the world?" Listen, that means, my dear listener, if you cannot overcome your own problems, personal problems, it is certainly that you do not have the Spirit of faith, the Spirit of God. Because if you do not overcome, the reason of your defeat is your doubts. Because doubts neutralize faith. Doubts does not does not neutralize the spirit of faith. When a person has the spirit of faith, which is God's spirit, whatever they are able to overcome. They are able to overcome whatever circumstance, whatever problem, because they are submerged with God's spirit. You can see that not even death was capable to keep Jesus. Not even death. Because the spirit that was within him, that came upon him, that dwelt in him, that guided him through the desert in order to be tempted by the devil, the spirit that was in Jesus made him to overcome even death. And even after death, in 3 days, he resurrected for the glory of our Father. And this is the spirit that God has given to us. He has given it to us. And that's the reason why that we bring people to this campaign that we are going to have on the 25th, on a Wednesday, in 2 weeks from now, that movement of faith, of a sacrifice of the 21 days. Imagine, Jesus, he made a fast to overcome the devil. If God made a fast, imagine our need to make a fast. But then the person may say, but Bishop, I cannot make a fast because I am under treatment, medical attention, I have to eat, I need to, you know, to take my medication. I am a person that I need to eat every 3 hours. So how can I make a fast? It's not the fast of food. This fast that we are dealing with is a fast that has nothing to do with food abstinence, but is a fast which is completely spiritual. A fast in which people, those that are interested, they are going to sacrifice their curiosity in order to abstain themselves. They are going to focus their life, to submerge only in the things of the Holy Spirit. Because it is impossible for a person to receive the Holy Spirit if they do not sacrifice. If they say, oh, I have made sacrifices, I gave my life to Jesus on the altar, I gave my life to Jesus. But when they leave the church, they continue living the same style of life that they have been living a long time. So what kind of sacrifice are they doing? So, the supposed salvation, the supposed belief that they have, is not justified because we know and God knows that their surrender on the altar was not sincere. But when a person wants to receive the Holy Spirit, they are obligated to make a sacrifice. They are obligated to make the sacrifice, because if they don't make the sacrifice, they don't receive. And obviously, there are many people that, unfortunately, they fool themselves, or they fool other people, or they allow themselves to be fooled by saying they have the Holy Spirit, but they have been losing their battles. They have been losing in life. And I'm not referring to, in regards to sentimental problem, or I couldn't get married yet, I couldn't overcome this disease, or I couldn't overcome this, my profession, my career. No, I'm not talking about that. I'm not talking about these things. When I say a person cannot overcome, is that they cannot overcome the depression. They cannot overcome their fears. They don't overcome their anxieties, their emotional being. They have sleepless nights. They have insomnia. They are nervous. They are a person that is angry. So these kind of people that manifest these, you know, show these kind of characteristics, depression, fear, nervousness, insomnia, constant headaches with no medical explanation. You know, these people that are always in doubt, they don't even overcome these problems. So how are they going to overcome the world? So then, my dear listener, this campaign of the Fast of Daniel, people that are interested, and only those that are interested, the ones that are thirsty, the ones that are willing to sacrifice their lives, if they're going to get married or not, it doesn't matter, it makes no difference. If they are going to conquer the blessings that God has promised or not, it doesn't matter. But they are going to submerge themselves with all their heart, with all their mind, with all their strength. They are going to think throughout 21 days only about the things of God. They are only going to feed themselves with the things from on high, from what is biblical. They are only going to listen to what is going to strengthen their faith and not to be distracted with foolishness, with soap opera, with sports, with entertainment, with news. They are going to put all these things aside. They're going to put their magazine on the side, newspaper, internet, social network. They are going to abstain from everything that is not of faith. That's what we call the fast. So then they say, but Bishop, I have the cell phone, you know, my mobile phone, and I keep on, you know, in communication with my friends and family. I know, but even that you are going to put aside if you want the Holy Spirit. You are going to have to put all your mind focused, all your understanding and your thoughts, everything in God. You're going to read more of the Bible. If you were reading less or not reading at all, you're going to read. We have a book called The Holy Spirit. So read this book. Meditate upon it. Meditate upon the Holy Spirit. You need to sacrifice. If you do not have this willingness, this sacrifice, how can you receive the Spirit of the living God? How? There is no way. There is no one in their conscience that they can receive the Holy Spirit if they are distracted with other things. No one. How many people, they come to church and they pray and pray and pray, and they do not receive the Holy Spirit. And why not? Because they enter inside the church as an adventure. They just came to visit, to take part of the service, as they do every single Sunday in many different churches. And like this, they will never have the Holy Spirit. Because you can, if you want to receive the Holy Spirit, you need to determine, to sacrifice, to put all your strength, to put all your understanding, all your thoughts into it. I know they are relatives, you're going to put them all aside. You know, social network, put all that aside. And you're going to be focused 100% only devoted to the things of God. The topic that does not talk about God, you are going to toss it in the trash. It will not come into your mind. You will not want to hear it throughout these 21 days. And when you make this sacrifice, truly, so then you are going to be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Certainly. The Holy Spirit then is the spirit of faith. He is the one who gave Jesus condition to overcome the devil, to overcome this world, to overcome everything, to overcome even death. But I ask you, if you receive the same spirit that gave Jesus victory, that resurrected Jesus, will he not resurrect you? If you receive the same Spirit that gave Jesus victory, will you not have victories? That's why the Bible says like this, that the one who has, or who, he who is of God, whoever is born of God, overcomes the world. And the victory that overcomes the world is our faith. And then it says more, another verse that says, who is it that overcomes the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? Read this scripture yourself. Who is it that overcomes the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? Who? Who can overcome the world if not the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? In other words, who believes, who overcomes the world if they do not believe in the Lord Jesus? There is nobody. No one.
Mas aí você diz assim,
but bishop, you may say, but bishop,
eu tenho
I have the conscience
de que sou filho de
that Deus. I am a child of God.
Mas eu
but
vou confessar também.
I'll confess
eu não
to
tenho
you,
vencido,
I have not overcome the world
as tentações,
because I cannot overcome my temptations. I have not been able to overcome my fascinations, my desires, my fleshly desires. I can't stop lying or little lies. I can't overcome my envy. I envy this one. I envy that one. I can't overcome malice that I carry inside me. So if you can't overcome these things, malice, thoughtful of malice, envy, if you can't overcome lies, if you can't overcome sins, your flesh desires, prostitution, promiscuity, if you can't overcome your own self, how can you overcome the world? And if you cannot overcome the world, in reality, you do not believe that Jesus is the Son of God. Because he who believes that he is the Son of God overcomes the world. And if you believe, you say you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, but you do not overcome, it's because in reality, you do not believe that Jesus is the Son of God. And this is the truth. Let us be frank. Let us, whether you are bishop, pastor, let us be smart. Regardless of who you are, if you are a pastor, lady pastor, whether you have a church or not, it doesn't matter your position in this world. When a person believes that Jesus is the Son of God and the Son of the Most High, they overcome the world. Because the one who believes in him, they are submerged in this spirit of faith, and they have God's spirit. And this is a fact. This is a reality and a fact, a true fact, because it is written in God's word. So, my dear listener, let us go back to the first verse we read. Let us meditate once again. 1 John 5. For whoever is born of God overcomes the world. If you do not overcome the world, it's because you are not born of God. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, our faith. So you overcome the world when you have the spirit of faith. The spirit of faith that comes from God. And then the following verse says, who is it that overcomes the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? To believe here is not the one to just believe and just say, no. It's to believe here is to live. is the one who assumes Jesus in their life. They take their faith in practice and they love him much more, greatly more than their relatives, than their children, their father, mother, and go on. But the point is this, that the son, daughter, whoever it is, the person does not put Jesus in first place. They don't love Jesus in first place if they have father, mother, somebody else in their mind, in their life. So then, this kind of person does not believe in the Lord Jesus. They believe, but they do not live. So like this, you cannot receive the Holy Spirit. Because you who believe, truly believe, receives the Spirit of God. It is not fair that I surrender my life 100% in the hands of the Lord Jesus and I assume my faith in Him regardless of my family, my friends, whether they like it or not that I do it. I assume my faith in any place, anywhere I go. If I am among unbelievers, I assume my faith even more. If I am among believers, I assume my faith. I stand firm upon my faith in any, with any person, any day, any time. So if I assume this faith and I'm firm on my faith upon the Lord Jesus, then I am saying that Jesus is the Son of God. So the Lord Jesus, the Son of God, blesses me with the Spirit of faith, with His Spirit, which is the Holy Spirit. And then I am able to overcome the world. So I want to tell you this one more thing. Pay attention for this. Listen to this. I ask, who can overcome doubts? Who can overcome doubts if they are not submerged in the Spirit of faith? Who can overcome the spirit of doubt if they are not submerged? If they are not submerged in the Spirit of faith? Because who can overcome doubts? Overcome the devil. Overcomes the world. Overcomes all. That's why God has been giving us the spirit of faith to overcome the spirit of doubt, of fear, of worry, of anxiety, nervousness, to overcome depression, to overcome anguish, emptiness, hell. God has given us the Holy Spirit, which is the spirit of faith, to overcome this world. And he who wants to overcome the world must sacrifice in order to receive the Holy Spirit. That's why on the 25th, from the 25th, we are going to have 21 days of the fast of Daniel. And I'm inviting you that are interested. But if you are a person, I'll try. Don't even try. Don't even do it. These 21 days, we are going to submerge together. We are going to think only about the things of God. We are going to submerge our thoughts only with the things of God. And doing this way, we are going to receive the Spirit of faith. You are going to receive, because I already have. Thanks be to God. Because I'm passing on to you is what God has been given to me. Is what He has been given to me. And whoever is interested to receive what I have, welcome in this campaign of 21 days of the Fast of Daniel from the 25th. Thanks be to God.
What an honor to know that I'm your child. You who are so infinite and holy. Whenever I am alone, you are there beside me. A Father such as you, so great, eternal. How precious is your presence within. Word words cannot express just how I feel. I know that when I'm standing in your presence, hope reaches out to you in heaven. Hear what I proclaim in faith to you. What an honor to have you live within me. What an honor to call upon you and receive. An honor, such a precious is your presence within me. Words cannot express just how I feel. I know that when I'm standing in your presence, hope reaches out to you in heaven.
I used to be very depressed. I used to feel very lonely. My parents used to argue at home, verbally and physically, throughout my entire childhood. I used to feel empty inside. I was always the outcast in my school. I would never have any friends. I would be the only girl sitting in the lunch table where people would always talk about me. I'd get bullied by many kids, boys and girls, in school. So I used to be very depressed to the point where I became suicidal. I used to cut myself in my arms, my legs. Get into a car accident, like go against a tree or a trailer that was in front of me. The other time was I attempted with a rope by myself in my room. I tried to like choke myself with the rope, but it didn't go all the way through the rope, so it failed. And that was, I felt like that was the only way out, that it was something that made me feel good from all the pain that I was going through. It was something that relieved the pain, the ease, and kept me sane throughout my depression and the difficult times I was going through. At home, my older sister and my younger sister would always get the attention, and the love and the affection I was looking for from my parents, I would never get it from them. So I tried to look for it outside in the world through having boyfriends and going from guy to guy. And unfortunately, I never found the real love. It was all temporary. I would always get cheated on, and I'd always get left like on the scene there. And I'd always feel depressed. Well, my first 21 days was, I decided that I wanted to change my life completely. And so I decided to do the 21 days when the pastor mentioned it. And I disconnected myself from all social media. I would start listening to church music. I would start reading the Bible more. I put God first. I prioritized Him first. I did more for Him and less for me, like with the things that I wanted to do. I stopped talking to many people that didn't benefit me, people that, and conversations that weren't worth it. And so I decided to go to church more, Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, and Sundays, and then Saturdays to evangelize. So I started doing more for God, and I put all my fleshly desires aside, and I decided to make a change because I wanted a change in my life. I didn't like living the way I was living. The hardest thing to sacrifice during the 21 days of Daniel was social media, Instagram, Snapchat. It was always a big part of my life because in the past, I used to never talk to my sisters or anything, so I would always communicate myself with friends and behind all of that. So giving up Snapchat and Instagram, it was like giving up my life, you know, because it was a huge part of my life. Well, the peace of having the Spirit of God is, it's great. Like when I go home, my house is full of peace. There may be problems here and there, but the problems just go away. They disappear. And there's more peace within me, my sisters, my parents. Well, now I'm more happy. I feel like I don't need to go from guy to find the happiness. Now I do more for God and less for me. You know, I put God before everything. My studies is very important to me. It's always been a huge part of my life, but I always put God before it. Now, if I have to go to service on Wednesdays and Fridays and Sundays, it's like a joy to go. I can't wait for those days to come so that I can go to service or I can just be in the presence of God. I would, even if I have a test the next day and I didn't study for it, I still always go to service first and then I study, even if it's staying up till 3 a.m, writing a paper, whatever it may be, I still go because God gave me this happiness, He filled me with His Spirit, and I feel like I can do so much, I have to do so much more for Him.
The voice inside of me was anger. I used to get angry so much, and especially when I got mad, I used to do a lot of crazy stuff. Especially a person like me, I used to be around gun all the time. So that voice was getting destroyed my life. It getting so bad because the same anger caused me to get locked up so many times because I couldn't control it. I did a lot of things. I thought it was like, if I get more money, I would be happy. It wasn't. I think travel all over the world, meet all kind of different female, it was gonna be to close this emptiness that I have inside of me, but it didn't. I find about the 21 days, the first time when I came to the church, it was telling me about the 21 days. But I tried it, but I didn't finish. And the second time, and when the 21 days came, and I decided to do it till the end, that's when I start taking that for very seriously. I take it straight, and I was like, stay away from everybody I know that come with a negative talk. And I used to talk a lot about my friend back home. I cut all this thing off. All of my mind was to seek for God more. Because that time, I used to love TV. I love basketball. I love watch soccer. And I'm a type of person who used to talk a lot on the phone. And I talk a lot of female on the phone. That time, I take all these things away from me. And then I just saved myself to seek for God. When I receive the Holy Spirit, the first thing that I see in me is I come, because I have a lot of anger. I very calm, and then I didn't have peace inside of me. I have peace, and I never communicate with people. Every time I talk to somebody, it's always gonna be a problem that I have to, if I don't pull a gun, if I don't get mad and do crazy stuff, and I can feel that these things not there anymore. I can feel that I'm a different person. The number one that I find in me is that I didn't ever want people around me. I'm a type of person that I always want to be by myself because I know what type of person I am. So, and I start talking to people. I start like, I can feel that inside of me that I want to help people because I'm a type of person that in my past, I used to be a person that do a lot of things to use people. I can see that I don't have that type. I'm not a type of person anymore to use people. I start helping people more. People around me, they really see that I'm changed because I used to have this anger is to control me. I didn't have a power to control this anger. I can see like when people now see me, they're like, something gotta be wrong. It's not the same person that I know, D'Angelo that I know. Now why you so calm? I say, my friend, it's only God that's controlling me because I didn't have the control of my own self. But now they can see it. Even when I talk to my people back home, they can see I really sound different person. Even my mom's like, I just can't be, I want to see you. Because the way you talk now, I can feel that inside of you, you have peace.
Everyone who does not submit to God's word brings to themselves destruction to their life. Even though they have faith, goals, and dreams, if there is no obedience to God's word, they will certainly be rejected by God. God sees the heart and recognizes those who fear Him and keep their word. And these are the ones who want eternal life, are humbling themselves, repents from their wicked ways, and seek the throne of grace and mercy of God. The Universal Church, empowering lives with the Word of God.
All that I have, I'll sell all to hold in my hand the pearl. Nothing I have can compare with the prize when I hold in my hand the pearl. Brighter than sun, clearer than glass, dearer than gold, the pearl. Kingdom of God, it's the kingdom of God, it's life with my Lord, the pearl. All that I have is ashes, is earth, now that I've seen the pearl. And I will not rest, I cannot be content, till at last it is mine forever to shine. The kingdom of God, the pearl. Let me gather everything I own, all that in this dreary world I've known. Pleasures and possessions now I bring, trade them for one single shining. It is mine forever to shine, the kingdom of God, the
truth, love, and your justice.
strength.